guys, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is a spin on the Tekken cover. If you remember that hairstyle from years and years ago, it's one of my very favorite hairstyles that I've ever done. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and if you want to see how to recreate this look, then just keep watching. For this hairstyle, I've got my hair parted on the right side, though you could part it wherever you normally prefer. Then I'm going to divide out the front section of hair for my braid, so about 4 inches back from the hairline, I'm going to create a zigzag part on the left side. Then using a clip, I'm going to pin back the hair at my crown to keep it out of the way. Now I'm going to pick up a section of hair for my braid, so I'm just dividing off a small slice near the part and splitting this into 3 smaller pieces. Since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the right and left sides. And after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to start incorporating new pieces of hair into the braid on both sides. I'm only going to bring in 2 extra pieces on the right side of the braid, but on the left side I'm going to pull in 4 pieces, and then stop adding in new sections of hair and just continue braiding the rest of the hair to the ends in a regular 3-strand braid. Then I'm just going to continue braiding the section down to the ends and slide some bobby pins over the bottom. Now starting in the middle of the braid, I'm going to gently pull on the outside edges of both sides of the braid to make it look wider. And I like to start in the middle of the braid, working my way up, and then go back to the bottom portion of the braid. Now I'm going to divide out a new section of hair on the right side of my head to use for a second Dutch braid. So I'm just going to do another zigzag part like I did before, clipping away the hair at my crown so it stays out of the way. Then I'm picking up a small slice of hair near the part, dividing it into 3 smaller pieces for the braid. And again, since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand instead of over the top, so the braid sits out on top of the hair. And I'm going to pull in about 4 sections of hair on both sides of the braid, while leaving out a small slice of hair along the hairline. Then I'm just going to continue braiding the section down to the ends in a regular 3-strand braid, and slide some bobby pins over the bottom. Then once that's done, I'm going to bring the 2 braids together at the back of my head and tie them together using a clear elastic band. Now I'm going to do the updo portion of the hairstyle, so I'm going to take a small section of hair from behind my right ear and loop this around the braid. Then I'm going to take another section of hair along with the ends from the first section and tuck this around the braid as well. Then I'm going to do one more section, so I've wrapped all of the hair from the right side. And now I'm going to grab some bobby pins and use these to secure the wrapped pieces in place. I'm not going to open the bobby pins, but instead I'm just going to hook a little section of hair and then push it down into the hair behind the braid. Once the hair feels nice and secured, I'm going to move over to the hair on the left side of my head and repeat the same steps, taking small sections of hair, wrapping them around the braid. Then once I get to the hair at the very center, I'm going to wrap this around the braid until all of the hair is tucked in underneath. And then I'm just going to slide in some bobby pins until it feels nice and secured in place and won't fall loose. I'm so in love with this hairstyle. I really love how it turned out. I hope you enjoyed seeing how to recreate it and try it out for yourself at home. Let me know in the comments section what you think about this hairstyle and how you would style it. Also, if you want to see more hairstyles that are similar to this one, make sure to click the thumbs up and I will be sure to film some more that are similar. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. That way you won't miss out on any future videos. Thank you again for watching as always, and I will see you next time.